Welcome to Soaping 101. Today we're creating a scrumptious bath bomb treat. We'll begin by adding water-soluble dye to the water portion of our bath bomb recipe. Adding the colorant as a liquid eliminates the clumps often found in powdered dye. Let's create the bath bomb mixture. First, baking soda. And I spend a little extra effort to break up any large clumps. In goes our color. A quick whisk, and then I get in with my hands. I rub the powder in between my palms. You can tell when all the colors combined when you don't see any streaks. Next, we add the carrier oil. I'm using fractionated coconut oil because it's non-greasy and won't make the tub slick. In goes my fragrance oil. Strawberry, of course. Mix well all the liquids into the baking soda. By adding these before we add the citric acid, we'll keep the mixture from activating or fizzing. This ingredient is optional, but I'm adding SLSA. It's a foaming agent. It creates a nice slow bubbling action to your bath bomb. Once blended, let's add the citric acid. The recipe for this bath bomb mixture is located in the description box below. After passing the hold together test, it's time to mold. A little tip. Ahead of time, I created a wax impression of the waffle. This will save time and frustration when pressing into all the little cavities. It also adds even pressure and gets into the corners. Use the back side of the waffle impression to form a flat surface. Just keep filling and pressing and set aside to harden overnight. Meanwhile, we'll create some strawberries from Melt and Pour soap just for decoration. Fragrance and colorants is added and stirred in well. And once cooled, we can dust the stems with a little bit more mica. So darn cute. Because our waffles are over-the-top decadent, we need to create some faux whipped topping. We'll do this with bubble icing. Baking soda, cream of tartar, and SLSA are added to the bowl. Thank you. Now our liquid ingredients, glycerin and fragrance oil. And give it a good mix. Our final ingredient is cocoa betaine. This is a bubbling agent and also thins out our mixture to form a frosting. Stir gently as not to incorporate too many air bubbles. The full recipe is also located in the description box. You can see the consistency as I fill the piping bag. If your frosting is too thin, you can add a little bit more baking soda. So let's put our bath treat together. Create a little more melt and pour soap to drizzle over the top to mimic strawberry sauce. A few dollops of frosting will bind the two waffles together, and once the frosting is set up overnight, it will be rock hard. And for our final touch, our little strawberry. Here's an example of how it fizzes in the tub. I hope you'll try this out for yourself, and be sure to tag Soaping 101 on social media if you do. Well, that's all for now. Thanks so much for watching. And I'll see you all next time.